that happens that makes you forget about it. I think people move down anyway because the football lockout costs you no games, and basketball you're still getting a decent schedule, but you're getting a storyline that makes you forget everything that happened in the lockout and the fighting and the nonsense that went back and forth. To have the new CBA, to have the season going on, and something to really watch and focus on. Because, listen, you guys hear and see the scores every day. LeBron has this, Kobe has that, you know, Tim Duncan, you know, has his double-double. We're talking about all these, a lot of the same guys over and over and over again. So you get a story like this, you grab onto it, because it is such a great story. And it is so different than Tebow. In the beginning, that this guy was very close to just sliding on through and nothing ever happening. You know, sliding on through, getting ready to pack your bags and go over to Europe when he got cut by the Knicks. He was ready to do that. And just, you know, off into oblivion, he was already there. He was actually already there. And he was going to go farther into it. But he gets his one moment. That's a message to try and tell to young men and women out there as they prepare to do something. You never know when your chance is going to come about. And when your chance comes about, that's why you prepare. And sometimes it feels like you're banging your head off the wall. You're working and you're working and you're working, and you're not getting where you want to be. You're not getting where you want to be. Not only that, you're not even getting the chance to be where you want to be. But you know what? That moment can happen. Doesn't happen all the time, but it can happen. Are you ready when you're called upon? And Jeremy Lin was ready when he was called upon. And for those who would try and make an argument because you have some reason to want to, that this is being manufactured, that this is being blown up because it's New York, or being blown up because of the uniqueness of your cultural heritage, or because of any other reason you want. The fact is, the numbers are in your face. I mean, he has scored the most points of any player who began his career since the merger in his first 5 starts, the most of any. And he's the only player since the merger to go undefeated and score at least 20 points in each of his first 5 career starts. The only one is Shaq Harrington Elias' 4th year. No other player since the merger has scored at least 20 points in one each of his first 5 NBA starts. No one. Not Shaq, not Michael, not anyone. So if you want to try and downplay this for whatever reason you may want to, well, okay, feel free to live in that world if you want. But it's going to be a fairly lonely place if it's one without any data to back you up whatsoever. You have no argument. You have no basis, no foundation from which to make that argument. All of the facts are going against you. We're not going to make much more on this all morning long, and hypocrisy on display in 3 minutes with Michael Madison.